All right. Our next caller, I believe, is Bruce. Bruce, welcome to The Narrow Path. Thanks for calling.
Thank you. I have a couple of questions about some verses in Ephesians, chapter 2, 6 and 7, and chapter 3, verse 10.
Okay.
It says, "And God raised us up with Christ and seated us with him in the heavenly realms in Christ Jesus, in order that in the coming ages he might show the incomparable riches of his grace expressed in his kindness to us in Christ Jesus." Then going to 3:10, it says, "His intent was that now, through the church, the manifold wisdom of God could be made known to the rulers and authorities in the heavenly realms." My questions are we just pawns in some cosmic game? And two, he's the creator and they're created. Why are they even worthy opponents? And three, from a Calvinist standpoint, this is just being done to show these heavenly beings something that seems like it goes against Calvinism because it was predetermined. How could it even be impressive to these heavenly beings? So they're all kind of related questions.
Yeah. Well, are we pawns? No, we're not pawns, but we are given the privilege of bringing glory to our Creator, which is what anyone who loves God would want to do. And it's good to know that what God has done in our lives has brought glory to him, in that the principalities and powers, or the angels and the demons, are looking on with wonder and seeing how wise he has been. He has been extremely wise and good. And I think that anyone who's wise and good should be respected for that, especially if it's God, who owes no goodness to anybody, but is just good because of how good he is. I would have no objection to finding out that all that God has done in my life has brought him glory and has caused principalities and powers to be impressed with his wisdom. I'm impressed with it. I think everybody should be. So I wouldn't see myself in this sense as a pawn in a game. I would just see myself as a beneficiary of a wonderful work of grace, which is doesn't only impress me, but impresses all onlookers, and should, you know, that God should be glorified is my desire. Why should created beings be a worthy opponent to him? Well, I don't think anyone is really a worthy opponent. There are people and demons that set themselves against God, and he basically does not just smash them like he could. He could smash everything like a bug. He could take the whole universe and clap his hands around it and smash it into a pancake and kill everything. But God isn't that way. He has managed to win without destroying his opponents. He has managed to win in spite of them. And I've often compared it to a chess master. His opponents may not be worthy of him because they're worse players than he is, but he still comes to the game, and he demonstrates that he is capable of winning the game without subduing them. That is to say, a chess player never subdues his opponent. He allows his opponent to make whatever moves they want to make. But because he's superior, he'll still win. He can counter. And I see this is what God has done. It's not that we are worthy opponents or that he's threatened by our abilities, but he has put himself at a slight disadvantage in deciding to let us do what we want to do. And yet, he needs to bring about his purposes in the world. So how he can bring about his purposes in the world, despite the fact that every participant has a free will and can oppose him if they choose, simply shows his tremendous wisdom and superiority. And I think that's probably what Paul is suggesting there.